All right, Playo, I finally got Jerry, you on here, man. Hey,
look, everybody call me Playo. I ain't tripping about that, but it's Jerry in Indiana. That's what I'm promoting now, Jerry in Indiana. It's still Playo, though.
Okay. So I got to ask, man, like, okay, so number one players, okay. Playo. What made you call yourself Jerry Indiana? Because I didn't know who Jerry Indiana actually was, and then I'm like, wait, you know, why is he doing that?
Yo, if you notice, if you really fuck with me, you know what I mean? You got playtime over value one, playtime over value two, zero tolerance, all that shit said Playo, aka Jerry Indiana.
Okay.
So, you know, my first name is Jerry, Indiana where I'm from, put the state on my back. That's what it is, man.
Okay, so I gotta ask this, man. Like, how does it feel being like the only person in Gary that's booking like major events like that? Like, usually, you don't see an event like this, especially at the Hammond Civic Center, unless like some major company is doing it. Like when they brought out Wayne and Black Youngster, Twista and shit. Now you're only one man. How does it feel doing this shit?
It's stressful. Shit, it's stressful. I gotta deal with all artists. I gotta deal with the booking agent. I gotta deal with the artist, the main artist. You know, I mean, it's a little stressful, but I do it for the city. You know what I mean? Because I'm trying to bring attention in our area. You know, I know it's at the Hammond Civic Center. I really was trying to do it at the Genesis Center.
Yeah, I was gonna ask about that.
I'm trying to do it at the Genesis Center, but they be playing. I'm from Gary, so I want to do it in Gary, but they didn't plan, so I had to bring it to the Hammond Civic Center. But it's still bringing attention to Northwest Indiana, and that's what all I'm trying to do. At the end of the day, I'm an artist too, so I book these big motherfuckers. You know, they bring out the crowd. I perform, and I get a check at the end of the night. It's a win-win situation. You know what I mean?
Okay. Now let's talk more about the Genesis Center situation. Like, do you feel that the Genesis Center would have been on games or something? What's going on?
I think they're scared. You know, and that's
okay.
And I hope they see this too, because
right.
You know, when somebody trying to bring business to art to the city, you know, bringing a big concert out here, that's creating jobs.
It would have made the city look good.
Yeah, it made the city look good. Police officers working, making that extra money.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody working, you know what I mean, making money. So you're creating jobs, the city looking good, and I don't understand why the city don't see that, you know what I mean? So
right.
I think it needs to be some new motherfuckers in the administration at the Genesis Center so we
right.
can make this shit happen, you know what I mean?
Okay. Okay, now when I first heard of you, Dave's Loaf was coming to town. It was about, I think, 2014.
Yeah,
what was it, the winter time?
Black Friday at Adriana's.
Okay, yeah, Black Friday. I remember being at the mall in Maryville at DTLR, and I was seeing the flyer, and you came down on an escalator. You was on your phone. I think you was in a big-ass coat or some shit. You had that chain on, and they told me that's who you was. I was with my older brothers who, you know, look up to you in the game. They said that guy with the chain is bringing it. So I'm like, okay, damn. So that's number one players and shit like that. You brought out the Ontario Hundun. Now you said
Kevin Gates.
Kevin Gates, okay. Can you talk about Kevin Gates and Young Dolph?
It was a good show, and it's crazy because I had the Adriana's.
Okay.
Well, it was booked at Adriana's. Adriana's got shut down, they had to shoot. So I had to move it over next door to Billboard Live, and I only had 2 days to promote that motherfucker. That motherfucker was still busting.
Oh wow.
Still busting.
Yeah, Kevin Gates and Dolph are big people, bro.
Yeah. He good people. He gave motherfuckers a whole show for real. He really put on a show. I fucks with Kevin Gates, you know what I mean? They need to let that nigga out of Chi-Raq. Let the nigga go home, get back to his business, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I heard he's in Chi-Raq right now.
Yeah, he's in Chi-Raq.
Okay. So you have all this like power, all these plugs, cash and everything. What makes you do shows with the artists instead of actually doing features and videos to put you on much quicker?
I mean, I remember I brought Ford to the G.
Okay.
He got locked up. I got a song with him called Voodoo.
Right.
So I do actually do features with him also, but you know, sometimes, you know, my mind be so focused on making sure the show is successful. And that's another thing that,
right.
you know, I'm about to slow down on. It's time to focus on my music, you know what I mean? Instead of everybody else booking these niggas, I'm spending my time on promoting these shows, and I can be spending that money on my shit and promote myself and building my value up with motherfuckers to pay me, you know what I mean? So,
right.
so yeah, that's what it is.
Okay. So basically, one thing, when we was out there in the gym, you was telling me about how you had to pay for everything. I thought you just called the people up. You pay the artist, of course. You had to pay for the stage and all of that shit. Do they?
Everything that's dealing with the show, you gotta pay for it all. The sound, the stage, the artist, the promo material, all the ads you see on running on Facebook, all that gotta be paid.
Even the passes and everything?
Passes,
damn.
The radio, all that shit, it's called a budget. You gotta know what type of budget you're gonna work with, and then you make it happen.
Okay, all right, cool. So what made you get into, you know, booking shows and everything like that? I've always wanted to know that. Like, what made you start doing that? Because a lot of people in Gary, they'll book people, but it's not as successful as, like, when it's behind number one players and stay focused. So, you know.
What really got me to doing it, because, you know, as an artist, I always wanted to perform at the big shows and shit like that. And motherfuckers tell me, oh, it's going to cost you a stack and all this and that. And I paid. I paid because I wanted to perform. So I got to the point where, like, you know what? Let me just do my own shit so I can be the supporting act. You know what I mean? So my name will be mentioned just as well as the main artist, and it's a way of promoting myself also. You know what
okay.
I mean? So that's the reason.
And that's
really
perfect.
Why I do it, you know what I mean?
Okay. What is the biggest event you have ever did? Like the biggest check you've ever seen behind this shit?
Biggest shit, man. I gotta say.
I know it's gonna be Dave's Low for Kevin Gates.
Yeah,
it was Dave's Low. Okay.
Black Friday.
Okay. Where was that at again?
The
Adriana's. Oh, damn.
Man,
okay.
Fit like 3,000 motherfuckers in that, man. That shit was busting.
Now, one thing I've always got to ask, though, like, Adriana's is a 21 and up club. I think that this event is actually going to bust because it's all ages. Like, what's your take on all ages and 21 and up? Which one do you actually like better, if you had to show
I'm going to see it today. It's my first all-age big event.
Okay.
I'm going to see it tonight.
And then
you go. And then I got an after party at the loft. You know
okay.
I mean? So
and he's going to be there too, right?
Yep.
Okay.
Try to get him up there, you know what I mean? So that's 21 and up at the loft. So shit, that's what it is. But I'm going to see tonight how this all-age shit go. I think all ages, you know, I got 11-year-old daughter, you know?
Right. And she lists to these same people.
She
okay.
The same people. She gonna be here tonight. You know what I mean?
Right.
So, you know, I think that all ages is a little better because you can fit more. You can get more people to come out. But then you have the discrepancy with the 21 and up. Like I don't want to party with the kids. So that's
right.
why. That's why I did what I did. You know, have the main concert for all ages and then do the after party for the 21 and up. I think that's the smart way to do it.
Okay. Okay. So now with your music. I actually like a lot of your videos, man. I looked at number one players. One time you guys had an epic video on the football field.
Yeah,
that was a nice ass Chrissy video.
Yeah,
right. And then there was another video you just did, the All the Way Up remix, you know, nice females and everything.
Yeah.
Do you have
from
a certain
the G too? That's all
oh, wow.
Candy from Gear.
Oh
all
damn.
All Candy from Gear. The cameraman was from Gear, the models was from Gear, and the artists was from Gear. You know what I mean? We got talent, right?
Damn, I feel a little shitty because all my models be from Chicago. But okay. So do you have like a certain concept with your music videos, or you in Hollywood just get up one day, hey, what's up, bro? Let's shoot something today.
Yeah,
that's what
so,
I, you know.
You try to think of a little treatment, you know what I'm saying? Especially for quick little videos, think of a quick treatment and go shoot it. You know, I got a video I'm gonna drop before in Wayne Blaze and Voodoo, and then Traffic Jam.
Oh, you got
Jam.
A video? Okay.
Yeah, then Traffic Jam, the song I just got done rehearsing. I got a video shoot for that June 3rd with Jay Visuals. That's
yeah.
dropping in a minute. You know what I mean? So
yeah.
trying to work.
Now, actually, funny you brought up Wayne Blaze. You know, my homie with the 4K camera, Mario Films, is actually his nephew.
Oh, what?
Yeah, they're close as hell.
Blood nephew. Song is Wayne Blaze on that song. So
wow.
In fact, maybe we need to see what he want to do. Maybe he can shoot the video. You know?
Yeah. So yeah, I didn't tell him that his uncle was on the song.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. So I actually think between you, there's Josan Tala, and there's another homie I met a couple nights ago, TSE Rizzle. I think you guys really got all of Gary, Indiana right now. I think the three of you guys really have it, you know, on everything, you know, promotion, whatever. So, you know, definitely want to hear good things about you. Is there any advice you have for fans that look up to you, like, as far as the club promotion, party promotion, music, all of that shit?
Yeah, all I want to say, whatever you're going to do, man, just like my record label, stay focused. Don't let shit deteriorate you. Don't let shit throw you off. Don't get into toxic relationships slowing you down. Stay focused on what you want to do, and I swear you can. The sky's the limit. You know what I mean?
Okay. Do you have any favorite city or states that you love doing business in?
LA.
LA? Okay, yeah, I love LA.
I make
LA
a lot
too.
Of money in LA. You know what I mean? My nigga Lil Baby said it. Shit. All Star Weekend, I was getting that pack in.
Okay.
That's what I was on.
Have you ever considered, you know, taking a VIP pass to the BET Awards? That's what I did a couple years ago. You know, getting into different programs.
Yeah. I'm trying to go to the BET Awards as an artist.
Okay.
Having me on that motherfucker. The BET Awards got the Psych Fight Awards. That's the Hip Hop Award.
No, that's the Hip Hop Awards.
Yeah. I'm trying to get the Psych for all that shit. Hey, it's gonna happen, man. It's gonna happen because I'm gonna stay focused at what I got going on. I'm about to go hard. Y'all gonna see a lot of this Jerry Indiana shit and Stay Focused ENT shit. I promise you that.
Okay. Now, Stay Focused ENT. Now, this is a record label, right?
Yeah.
Okay, are you looking to signing artists, or is it just something that you're doing with
right now,
people?
Yeah, right now I'm just doing it with, you know, me and my guys, number one players, and myself, you know. But once we get our foot in the door, we definitely gonna be signing other artists.
Okay, do you have anybody that you want to work with in the game? Anybody from your own city or elsewhere?
I'm open to working with whoever, you know. Whoever got good music, whoever's serious about their craft, I'm open to working with whoever that's serious.
Okay. Any interest in signing any deals or anything, you know?
Yeah.
Okay.
You heard blow all the way up, right?
Right.
So they got to come with a million from your signing, you know what I mean?
Okay. Yeah, definitely. Okay, cool.
But yeah, but if y'all want to follow me, stay focused, ENT, on all social
Instagram.
Media. You know, Jerry, Indiana. I'm one of them niggas.
All right, cool. All right, bro. Definitely want to hear some good things about you in the future. You're actually one of my personal favorites ever since 2014 when I heard of you. So, you know,
I appreciate
definitely.
It, dog.
All right, bro.
And fuck with my man. Fuck with my man, Cal.
Status update. Yes, got a status update.
Status update. Fuck with status update. You know what I mean? He doing what he got to do. He out here staying focused and making shit happen. He fucked with FBG Duck right now.
Oh, yeah. You know, shout out Duck. Shout out FBG.
Fuck with status update.
He was just watching the live, man.
Oh, that's dope. That's
dope. Okay, give us a sneak peek. Anything you got coming up as far as like the events or anything? Anything?
Only sneak peek I'm gonna give y'all right now is look out for that Voodoo single and that motherfucking Traffic Jam video.
Gotta invite me to that video shoot, man.
Get
all
you.
The behind
June 3rd.
The scenes. Okay.
June 3rd.
Is it in Gary or Chicago?
It's gonna be Chicago.
Okay, cool. All right, cool. Later.